Hello, welcome to the Tuesday, August 8th, 2017 edition of the Sands and Storm Center's Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich, and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. Xavier today wrote about the increase in scanning for PHP MyAdmin in his honeypots. Now, PHP MyAdmin is a PHP application that can be used to administer a MySQL database. And aside from it being often not properly secured, it often also suffers from unpatched vulnerabilities. Now, in the case that Xavier observed, the attacker was actually quite aggressive in trying to find a PHP MyAdmin using a variety of different URLs. Now, a lot of administrators try the security through obscurity trick and hide PHP MyAdmin. Personally, I don't really see a great reason why you need to have PHP MyAdmin installed in the first place. There are a lot of GUI applications that you can use to administer MySQL if you don't like the command line. And these GUI applications are really just the client applications that do not require a web interface. You just connect across the network, hopefully via SSL, to that MySQL database. Now, I have reported in the past about cases where VPN applications didn't actually provide much security or privacy. For example, there have been some Android applications that claimed to provide a VPN service but didn't actually encrypt the data. The latest case here is Anchor Free's Hotspot Shield. Now, Hotspot Shield does claim to provide free VPN services. And of course, whenever something is free, you have to look closely to figure out how are they actually paying their bills. In this particular case, apparently, they are injecting ads into your browsing stream. They will also inject JavaScript as part of these ads and essentially de-anonymize your browsing session to the advertiser. This is, of course, in particular ironic because one of the reasons that people do use these VPN services more and more is that some ISPs started now selling users' browsing data to advertisers. So Hotspot Shield essentially just becomes your ISP here. And that's really something to keep in mind, that a VPN provider like this essentially has the same role, the same access to traffic as your ISP, so pick it carefully so you're not falling for one that actually decreases your browsing security compared to your normal ISP. And Debian Linux, in its latest unstable development release, so this is not a production release yet, turned off TLS 1.0 and 1.1 support in its OpenSSL library. With that, only TLS 1.2 is supported. Now, while this makes some security sense, there are some weaknesses in TLS 1.0 and 1.1. The danger is that if you're using this branch, you're losing some backwards compatibility to systems that don't necessarily support TLS 1.2. One of the systems that may be affected here is, for example, some of the earlier Windows 7 versions, which do not have TLS 1.2 support enabled by default. Now you can enable it pretty easily, but what I'm a little bit afraid of is that for some of these systems, people will then fall back to non-SSL connections. And of course, that's probably worse than sticking with TLS 1.0 or 1.1. Some of the older Android versions also do not support TLS 1.2. And I talked last week about how two quite popular Google Chrome extensions were compromised via a phishing attack against the developer. Well, I mentioned that it's probably not the only Google Chrome extensions that were subject to this attack, and turns out now there were a couple others like Blue Messenger and WebStuff for Instagram. Apparently, these attacks started mid-June. It's one set of actors that is doing this very aggressively against large numbers of developers, and Google now notified developers to be careful with these attacks. The basic mode of operations is always the same for these attacks. A phishing attack is used to obtain the developer's username and password. Then the application is expanded using adware. The basic functionality of the application is apparently left alone. Just ads are being injected into anything, any website the user is browsing to. We had actually one user also complain that they all of a sudden saw some inappropriate ads on our website, which then turned out to be a compromised version of the web developer toolbar. Well, and that's it for today. Thanks and for listening, and talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.